Hi, and welcome to This is My Architecture. Today, I'm joined by Roche from Contino.
Hey, Fabio.
So Roche, to start, can you give us more details around what Contino is doing?
Sure. So Contino are a global digital transformation consultancy where we specialize in helping highly regulated industries become better at people, processes, and technology.
Okay, so we have a specific project here.
Yeah.
Can you give us more details around what issue does it solve?
Sure. So let's start off in the bottom left here with Control Tower.
Okay.
Now, Control Tower is an AWS solution that helps you set up a landing zone, effectively helping you to define what a good AWS estate looks like. And that's really important, so you can cover things around security, logging, auditing, and also gives you the ability to scale up your workloads as the demand in your business increases.
Okay. What problem are you solving with Flight Controller?
Yeah, good question. So Flight Controller aims to visualize the business impact that your landing zone is having. Think of it as a way to have a health check on the performance of your landing zone.
Cool. So how do you deploy it? How does it work? Can you give us more technical details around it?
Yeah, sure. So Flight Controller is an extension to Control Tower and takes 90 minutes to deploy into your environment by setting up a separate Flight Controller management account.
Oh, that's good. So all this stuff gets deployed and starts working after 90 minutes.
Correct.
That's good. That's very good. Okay, and now that works, how do you ingest the metrics? How do you fetch them?
Yeah, so let's take the scenario of a SRE team needing to deploy and bend a new account. Now, this account could be needed for testing purposes or deploying new workloads. In this case here, we can use AWS subscriptions to CloudWatch events, and we can listen for an event as soon as a new code pipeline is kicked off. We'll take that raw data and we'll put that into EventBridge.
Okay.
From there, we'll then use a Lambda to transform that raw data so we can pluck out key information, such as the resource that's been triggered, such as in this case, code pipeline, the time in which that happened, and other key metadata.
Okay, so the data is now enriched.
Yes.
I assume now you want to store it somewhere?
Yes.
Okay, where do you have to store it?
Yeah, it's a good question. So we actually store the data in two places. The first of which is into DynamoDB. And this is just so we can have the raw data so that in the future, if we need to access this data in any way, we have it available in one central location.
Okay, that's historical data.
Yes.
I assume you have something for visualization as well?
Absolutely. So if we go back to a Control Tower and our sprawling landing zone and our business, you can imagine that there's thousands of events that are happening all the time. And that's where we take advantage of TimeStream. And TimeStream is a really good way to measure time series data. So in this case here, when a code pipeline kicks off, we can sort that into TimeStream. And also when that code pipeline is finished, again, we can aggregate that data in one central location.
Okay, so a specialized database to store something that gets ingested very fast.
Yes, yes.
And then you will plug visualization into it, right?
Exactly that. So
okay.
This is where we use Grafana. And utilizing its SQL-like syntax so we can produce dashboards and visualizations. In this case, again, so we can see how performance our SRE and DevOps team are being in the account vending process.
Okay, so now I have the visualization and I have everything. How fast is this to ingest the data?
Yeah, so it's good to mention here, Fabio, that this whole architecture is serverless.
Oh, nice.
So from the point of an event being listened to in Code Pipeline or Systems Manager to it being visualized on Grafana takes under 20 seconds.
And you are just paying for the events that you want to ingest.
Exactly.
So yeah, you are in control, but you are paying the right price.
Yeah.
Okay, that makes sense. Is there anything, any other number that you could share about the infrastructure or any special area where you worked tirelessly to maintain it or to make it better?
Yeah, so out of the box, Flight Controller supports key KPIs and metrics, such as account vending times or patching times.
Okay.
But the beauty of this architecture that it's fully extensible by the client. And by that, we mean that you can define your own metrics by subscribing to the right events in your AWS account, and then shipping them into EventBridge and then defining further lambdas to transform that data in that specific case. So really, depending on the needs of your SRE team, you can have the right metrics to value what good looks like.
So the more the metrics, the more the lambda that would be executed, you just execute the one that you want and you just pay for the metrics that really matter to you.
Exactly that.
I see that it's pretty extensible. Would this part of the architecture work even for other metrics, something that is not related to Control Tower that maybe I want to measure?
Yeah, it's a really good point. So it supports Control Tower, but there's no reason that Flight Controller cannot support other types of landing zones and other third-party SaaS integrations. So you can have a great visibility, not over just your AWS account, but your whole entire backend process.
Yeah, anything that sits there and it's meaningful to the special customer.
Yeah.
No, that really makes sense. I think it's a very compelling architecture. I like the fact that it can be extended, so it's totally customizable for the end customers.
Yeah.
So thank you very much for sharing the architecture with us, Roche.
Thank you, Fabio.
And thank you for watching. This is My Architecture.